So it all started with me having a lot of data that I have collected over time, which I never want to throw away. And even worse, I actually want to carry most of them always with me, even when I'm traveling. I do have my own local storage server that I built. It's a little bit too big and not exactly travel friendly. I often have all my data in direct attached storages and then have them sync to my NAS on a regular cadence. So far, I've been using a few 2.5 inch hard drives in separate enclosures, but connecting all of them together is often a pain, which I described in a recent video. So I was trying to get a single enclosure which can fit about 4 drives, especially only for 2.5 inch drives, as it should keep the size manageable for our travels. However, when I started my research, I found that most of the enclosures that are available on market are both for 2.5 inch and 3.5 inch drive, because of which the sizes were pretty big for my use case. There are some available which are small, but the design is open and I wanted a closed enclosure. There is this Thunderbolt option available, the OWC Thunder Bay Mini. It costs about $350 with the soft read option and about $230 just for the enclosure. Also, I'm typically not a big fan of Thunderbolt devices as it limits my options to connect. My ideal solution was an enclosure very similar to the OWC one, but with a USB 3.2 Zen 2 10 Gbps interface and preferably a little cheaper. Now, for those who are thinking about the speed limit of 10 Gbps, it's typically okay for me as I don't normally use more than 2 drives at the same time, and considering SATA 3's limitation of 500 Mbps, it should be fine. That is when I started thinking about making my own enclosure. I found these 4-bay SATA 2.5 inch enclosures, which costs about $45. These have an integrated SATA backplane and an all-in-one SATA power input for the drives, which is neat. Once the drive gauge was settled, next thing I needed to figure out was what to do with the data connection. I chose to use an NVME enclosure here, which you can find as little as $20 these days, and this converts an NVME interface to an USB or Thunderbolt connection. It's pretty easy to expand the NVME M.2 slot to SATA connections using a SATA adapter card like this, which costs about $30. For the SATA connections to the cage, I'm using these unique SATA 90 cables, which has a reverse angle to make my life a bit easier for a cleaner fit. For power, initially I thought about using a direct DC to SATA or Molex adapter, but after doing some research, I found them to be not so reliable. The SATA power protocol supports both 5V and 12V inputs, and depending on the input power controller on the drives, it can pull different voltages which the direct voltage adapters may not be able to put out, leading up to an unstable drive or even failures sometimes. This is where a proper PSU comes into play that can send out a pure SATA power signal following all the protocols. I'm using a Pico PSU here, which is pretty compact, and you can find them as low as about $20. These take in a DC input somewhere in the range of 12V to 19V depending on which ones you get. These Pico PSUs are ATX compatible, so they need a jumper on the motherboard header to work. You can use any cheap jumper that often comes with normal PSUs. I picked up this fancy one for about $10, which has a switch as well. Now we have a neat little PSU setup ready to go, which we can use for our SATA power input to the drives. Please keep in mind that the 4 drives will need about 15 watts of power, so you'd want to match that in our Pico PSU and the corresponding DC power adapter that you use. Once we have all this sorted out, we need to just build it now. First, I took out the hot swap plates from the cage, attached the drives to the plates, and inserted the assemblies back into the cage. For the enclosure, I ended up using an old Thunderbolt one here as I had no other use for it, but you can use pretty much any enclosure that can support an M.2 NVMe drive like the USB one that I showed before. I installed the SATA adapter card and set the whole thing on the drive case using double-sided tape. I connected the SATA cables and cleaned it up a little bit for some easy cable management. At this point, it felt like a good idea to see if this was all working, which I did, and all drives showed up, which was a great sign. I retested the exact voltage from the adapter that I was using to make double sure that it's 12V as my Pico PSU needed. And then I attached the PSU onto the cage body, keeping in mind how the cables will be routed later. Please note that the components of the PSU can get hot, so I used a thermal pad to help dissipate the heat to the cage. The cage is made out of aluminum and should be able to handle it pretty well. I did some more cable management and then we were ready to move to the next phase. After all the connections were sorted out, all there was left to do was to build a case for this. Well, I should say extend the drive enclosure to be more accurate. The idea was to build a metal extension bracket and then cover up the rest with plastics. I took some measurements, drew out the shapes for reference, and cut a 1mm aluminum plate to fit it as an outer layer of the enclosure. These enclosures are typically designed to go into a PC case in the 5-inch slots, so they already have holes in there for connection, which I can use to connect the metal bracket. For the remainder of the case, I added an ABS plastic piece in the front, mostly using glue, For the backside, I took another ABS plastic sheet, made some holes for the USB input, the power barrel jack and the jumper switch, and connected it to cover the rest of the case. I used some black corner guards to get rid of the sharp aluminum edges and also add some really nice aesthetics to the final product. Overall, the whole enclosure feels pretty rugged for what it is and perfectly rigid for carrying it in a carry-on bag for my travels. So if you're planning to build something similar, expect to spend about $45 for the SATA enclosure, $20 for the NVME enclosure, $35 for the SATA to NVME converter, $25 for the Pico PSU, $10 for the adapter, and $10 for other miscellaneous stuff, which brings the total price to less than $150, which is pretty much lower than even the most affordable options out there. Also, if you don't mind waiting for delivery a little bit, you can source all of these from AliExpress for much less. The closest match to this one is the Sabrent tower enclosure, which is not bad, but it comes with Gen 1 5Gbps speed, which is a little less for 4 drives in my opinion. The best part of this build is that you can pretty much recreate the same build for more than 4 drives, use more NVMe enclosures if you think you need more than one connection, etc., and the possibility is endless. Even with 4 drives, you can still set up an all SSD DAS with up to 32TB of fast SSD local storage, which is an amazing amount of storage to have and to be traveling with. I plan to upgrade this build to convert it to a full service NAS, which will be pretty interesting and a challenging project, so do get subscribed if you're interested in that. I tested out the enclosure with various machines and I'm currently using it for my main rig and it's working great. If you have any suggestions for improvements or have other ideas for similar products, do let me know in the comments and I will try to work on it. Finally, I have a small giveaway. If you remember from the very first video in the channel, I built this wireless keyboard converter that converts a wired keyboard or any other wired devices for that matter to a wireless counterpart that needs a power connection. There were two key things that we needed for that build, a small battery pack and this BD500 module. I had an extra set of these lying around which I wanted to give to one of you guys. So if you're interested, please add a comment to the video and hit subscribe to my channel and I will select one of you to send this out. As always, thanks for tuning in, I'll see you in the next one.